Bernardino, California. The 1988 Miss Teen USA pageant with 51 of the most beautiful young women in the USA competing for more than $150,000 in prizes. Stars of our show, the reigning Miss Teen USA, Kristi Addis. The beautiful star of television and movies, Tracy Scoggin. One of America's most famous TV personalities, Dick Clark.
District of Columbia.
contestants for the title of Miss Teen USA 1988.
Wishing and praying and hoping and saying it's gonna be my night tonight.
Gentlemen, please welcome back our host for this evening, Dick Clark.
Thank you very, very much. Thank you, and greetings from San Bernardino and the fantastic Inland Empire of Southern California. Gonna be a good night. Now, we're here with music and dancing and 50 excited and anxious teenagers and an audience of thousands right here and millions all across the world. And more popcorn than I've seen in my whole lifetime. Thank you, Orville Redenbacher. Now, you're gonna see it all live from right here at the famous Orange Pavilion. Now, live is a very magic word in television. It creates a very special bond between all of us here. And you're a part of everything that happens as it happens. And there's also the added plus of having a beautiful woman with us sharing a very special evening and helping us to learn a little more about our pageant and the contestants. Please welcome the very talented screen and television actress, Tracy Scoggin.
I want to begin the evening with a welcome and a warning. Now, the welcome is for you, Dick, hosting your first Miss Teen USA pageant. Glad to have you. The warning is for all of you at home who'll be judging right along with our celebrity panel, because it's not going to be easy for you or for them to pick a winner.
You know, Tracy's right. I've been watching all during the rehearsals. I've been trying to find that one young lady, you know, who is a sure shot, but there's so many potential winners here. I got to confess, I don't have a clue.
Well, Dick, we have just the clue to help you out. And it'll start with a swimsuit fashion show using the beautiful scenery of the Inland Empire as our backdrop. And it features our 50 contestants in swimwear by Catalina Jr. But there is one catch.
There's always a catch.
Always. Along with the fashion show, the home television audience will get to see the scores each contestant received in the preliminary swimsuit competition. Now, no one here, including the judges, will be able to see those scores.
Now, that sounds like a real good deal for you at home. May I suggest that you get a pencil, piece of paper ready, and keep up with the scoring. Welcome back to the 1988 Miss Teen USA pageant, and please welcome back our 50 contestants wearing their outfits from Catalina Jr. All look beautiful. Now, following the naming of our 10 semifinalists, you'll see them compete in three categories: interviews, swimsuits, and evening gowns, after which the field will narrow to 5 finalists. And from those 5, our new Miss Teen USA will be chosen. But in a moment, 10 young women will be given the chance to continue their pursuit of our crown and the more than $150,000 in cash and merchandise that goes with it. And that moment is right now.
While Dick is getting the computer printout, a quick reminder. You at home will see the average score each semifinalist received in our preliminary competition, but they won't be shown here to our audience, to our judges, or to our contestants. Looks like he's ready. Let's listen.
Did you hear the little squeal go up when I picked up the piece of paper? You realize what's going to happen now. We narrow this down to 10. This is a biggie. The names will be read, ladies, in no particular order. Good luck to all of you. The first of the 10 is Miss Alabama. ready. The second name on the list is Miss New Jersey. Imagine what's going on in their minds right now. Get me on the list of 10. The third name is Miss Mississippi. The next name, Miss Oregon. Nervous as you folks are, hang in. The next name is Miss New York. All right, now that's 5 out of 10. Don't give up, ladies. There are 5 more names still to come. Maybe yours will be there. The next name is Miss West Virginia. Got 4 more to go, 4 more, one of which is Miss Texas. That's what's called a, 3 names left, 3 names. Miss New Mexico. Ladies, we are down to 2, down to 2, one of which is Miss Louisiana. This is tough. This is where I wish we could say everybody come down. We only have 1 name left, and that is Miss Illinois. Ladies and gentlemen, there they are, the 10 semifinalists for the title of Miss Teen USA 1988.
Well, Dick has just introduced the new Miss Teen USA. The big question, of course, is which one of the 10 will it be? The first challenge for our 10 semifinalists is the interview competition. And that starts right after this from Scope.
Miss Teen USA from San Bernardino will continue after these words.
Now, this is an outstanding example of what makes live television so very special. On these teenage semifinalists are not only going to do unrehearsed interviews in front of millions of people, but they're going to be judged on how well they do it. And they've got no idea of the questions. Now, as a man who's been interviewing teenagers for a lot of years, trust me, you never know what they're going to say. And we're live. And with that in mind, let us begin our chats with Miss Alabama. This is Anna Mingus. She's 18 years of age, a recent graduate of Enterprise High School, and along with our Miss Tennessee, was voted Miss Amity by our delegates. Congratulations. That means you must be a friendly person. You make friends easily?
I'd like to think so.
You know, I would imagine that you had had experience in that. Have you traveled a lot?
Yes, my father was in the Army, so with him being in the Army, we had to travel a lot. And I was constantly having to make new friends. And believe it or not, I used to be very shy.
You're not shy anymore.
No, having to make new friends helps you come out of the shyness.
Is it true? They told me in Enterprise, Alabama, they have a monument to an insect?
Yes, we are the only town in the whole world that has a monument dedicated to an insect. insect, and that's the boll weevil monument.
Would there be any reason for that other than everybody else doesn't have one?
Yes, in the turn of the century, the boll weevil set into Alabama and destroyed all the cotton crop. So it helped the farmers plant different crops and become more profitable.
Let me change subject for half a second. You're going to graduate, you have graduated
yes,
high school?
I have.
Are you going to attend college?
Yes.
What are you going to study?
Broadcast journalism. I want to be another Walter Cronkite.
Let me hear you say, and that's the way it was.
And that's the way it was.
Fair enough. Go take a spot over here, and we'll... That's Miss Alabama. All right, now. Let's say hello to Miss New Jersey. This is Michelle Knipfelberg. She is a recent high school graduate, lives in Edison, where she's active in the community's Safe Rides program. What's a Safe Rides program, Michelle?
Safe Rides is an organization we have at my school, and what we do is we go pick up students that are either drunk and can't drive home, or just people that just don't have a ride home, and we give them a safe ride home.
All right. Sounds like good activity. You're going to attend Montclair State College in the fall. What are your study plans?
I plan to study child psychology.
If you were going to raise children of your own, how would you do it?
Exactly the same way my parents raised me.
Tell me in a couple of seconds or so the way they've treated you and what they've taught you along the way.
My parents have taught me very good values. I think I have a lot of morals and great values, and I would just do the same thing for my children.
Do you think that women in this day and age can combine a career and raising children at the same time?
I think they can, as long as they give their children lots of love and attention.
There's a lot of luck involved in this, but I'd be curious to know, what would be the ideal family? How many kids in your life in the future?
I don't know. I'll have my first one, and then I'll decide from then, but probably many.
Many?
Yes.
All right. Thank you so very much. Pick spot over here, if you will. That's Miss New Jersey. Coming up next, say hello to Miss Mississippi. Now, this is Honey East. She's 16 years of age. She's from Jackson. She's the vice president of her class for 3 years in a row. Is a member of her school's cum laude society. That's pretty prestigious. Have you had good grades all your life?
I sure have. The last time I got a B was in second grade, and that was in spelling. So I've never been able to spell, but...
You mean to tell me you've had straight A's all the way through?
That's right.
Wow. What happened to spelling?
I don't know. I guess somebody told me to spell Mississippi with a crooked letter. I'm really not sure.
Right, now, honey, obviously you've answered this question 1,000 times, but is that a nickname or was that your given name?
That is my given name. My real name is Honey.
If some guy whistles on and says, hey, honey, you just turn around normally?
I sure do. And in the grocery stores, it's horrible because wives are calling their husbands honey and you know, husbands are calling their kids honey, and my mom's calling me honey, and I don't know who to look at.
Now, a quick change here. In the future, they told me you're going to do something. You say, you ask her, she'll tell you, you won't have any idea in a billy goat what she's talking about. What do you want to do off in the future?
I want to become a biotech intellectual property attorney.
Tell me in 2 seconds what the devil that is.
It's a patent attorney for genetic engineering.
Perry Mason never had it like this. Thank you, my dear. We'll see you over there in a second. Thank you, honey. That's Miss Mississippi. Let's greet Miss Oregon now. This is Mindy Duncan. Mindy's a 16-year-old honor student at Newberg High School. She's active in dance, soccer, and Special Olympics. And where did you get the red hair?
From my grandfather.
He's the only redhead around in recent years?
Other than my sister, yep.
I love it. All right. Now, did you grow up being called Red or something like that?
Yep, Red. That was my grandfather's name, too. So I kind of picked it up from school and from friends and stuff.
Somebody told me that you have for years prepared your father's lunch.
Yes, I have. Dad loves peanut butter and jelly, but his favorite is pocket bread sandwiches.
You mean his taste has changed over the years, or yeah. Your expertise has
My
changed?
My expertise has definitely changed.
Well, I'm sorry.
That's okay. I don't make those peanut butter and jelly for him anymore.
All right, fair. You have been specially selected by your school's faculty for student training in the drug impact program. What is that?
Well, in October, I was impact trained, which is a one-week seminar that you go to. It's a high-intensity training, which more or less gives you the ability to talk with youths in our school that have drug impact problems.
If somebody your age came to you, if they were one of your real good friends and they had a drug hang-up, what would you say to them?
I'd first of all ask them if they were really serious about quitting, because they have to come to terms that they do have a problem and they want to quit. And then I would tell them that I support them, which I do, and I would tell them where to go.
Thank you very much. I'm going to tell you to head right over there now.
Thank you
so very much. That's Miss Oregon. Next is Miss New York, and this is Jessica Collins. She's 17 years old from Amsterdam, where she's active in the Big Brother Big Sister program. And welcome to California. You're a long way from home. You like it out here?
I love it. It's been great. We've had just a wonderful time here. And I think one of my most memorable experiences I'll take back is that we took a trip to Universal Studios in Los Angeles.
You met King Kong.
I got to meet two of my favorite actors, King Kong and Jaws.
Two of your favorite actors? You and I got to talk later. What is the Big Brother Big Sister program?
Well, it's a program for children who come from single-parent homes. And no one knows how wonderful this organization is better than I do, because I myself was a little sister when I was younger. And I owe a lot to the program. And as Miss New York, I've been able to do a lot promoting the program. And it's just a wonderful feeling to know that you're giving back to an organization that gave you so much.
All right, now, this is a sneaky question, but we got a babysitter of yours here in the audience. You know she's here?
Yes, she's here. Her name is Ruth Zakarian, and she was the first Miss Teen USA ever.
And she was your babysitter?
She was my babysitter. We lived right across the street from each
other. Ruth, are you out there somewhere? Would you stand up and let us take a peek at you? Ah, there you are. What kind of a kid was she when she was little? Was she, was she an easy kid to take care of? Don't answer. Thank you so very much.
Thank you very much.
That's Miss New York. All right, now, we have completed half of the interview competition. That leaves us with five more interviews still to come.
Our contestants are competing for the crown and the title that currently belongs to this lovely young lady from Mississippi, the reigning Miss Teen USA, Kristi Addis. Now, Kristi, what do you suppose these girls are thinking right now?
Well, it's a funny mixture. The competitor in them is saying, I've got to listen and give good answers, and I wish I knew what he was going to ask. But the teenager in them is saying, oh my gosh, I made the top 10 and I've really got a chance to win now.
So it's like part of him wants to play it real cool and the other part wants to jump up and down and scream.
Exactly.
Well, five more semifinalists will face the Keep Your Cool test as the interview competition continues right after this.
I have everybody in order. We're ready now to hear from our second five semifinalists in the Miss Teen USA interview competition, and we will begin with Miss West Virginia, Wendy Stevens, who's 18-year-old graduate from Parkersburg High School, where she was an honor student and recipient of the President's Physical Fitness Award. How are you?
I'm fine. How are you?
Well, so far, so good. I was reading here that you may want to open your own health fitness center someday.
That's right.
How long have you been into that?
I've had an interest in it for a really long time. What I'm going to be going into is known as corporate fitness. And what it is planning out diet and nutrition programs for major corporations for their workers, because people are becoming more conscientious about having healthy workers all over the world.
What do you do to personally stay healthy?
I exercise and I make sure that I have a healthy diet. I basically just do the things necessary, like drinking water and keeping a healthy diet.
Let me change the subject a second. You could have spent the past 3 weeks relaxing on a beach somewhere, taking it easy. You've been working like a dog here. Why did you want to be a contestant?
Why would anyone? It's just a great opportunity for anyone.
Isn't it an experience that will help you in the future?
Oh, definitely. It most certainly is. I've learned so much at the pageant about meeting new people and making the most out of everything that you have an opportunity to do in your life.
It's a little bit exciting to appear in front of a few million people at one time.
Yes, it is. Hi, everyone.
That's for everybody back home in West Virginia. Jump over there and we'll join in a little bit. All right, that's Miss West Virginia. All righty. Let's say hello to Miss Texas. This is Libby Pelton. She's 18 years of age. She's from Austin. Voted class favorite all 4 years of high school. Recipient of a scholarship to Concordia Lutheran University. What are you planning on studying?
Well, I hope to major in communication and someday be a newscaster.
Meet Walter Cronkite. She's over here. Why is it so many young women want to go into broadcast journalism these days?
Well, I don't know about other women, but I know I love to travel and I love to meet people. And I just feel like it'd be a wonderful experience on each of my, you know, appearances meeting people. And I just would like to be a communicator and meet new people.
Is it true that you are a football fan?
Yes, this is true. I'm from Texas, and Texas is real known for their football.
No, but there's another reason, is there not? I'm prying a little bit, digging into your personal, but see, my spies have been at work.
Okay, you're right.
Now, tell, fess up.
I have a boyfriend that's now playing in New York for the Buffalo Bills, and I'm very proud of him.
All right, let me do a little testing on you now. Is he educated in the rules of football?
A little bit. He's trying.
What is this?
Timeout.
What's this?
Touchdown.
This?
Clipping?
Yeah, she said hesitating. You're passed. That's all I know for sure. Thank you so very much. Nice to have you with us. This is Miss Texas. Next is Miss New Mexico. This is Jill Vasquez. She's an 18-year-old graduate of El Dorado High School in Albuquerque, where she was a cheerleader and a member of the student council. Going to be attending San Diego State this fall. San Diego's right down the line. What are you going to study?
I'm going to major in marketing, and I'm going to just look around with marine biology because I'm fascinated by sharks and dolphins.
Marine biology and marketing both?
I'm just going to play with the idea of marine biology, but marketing is very practical.
You know, it's interesting because people these days are into saving the atmosphere and the seas and so forth. Do you have any experience? Have you ever been underwater?
I've been underwater a lot, but I just love their behavior. It's fascinating.
Doesn't frighten you at all?
Not at all. I love it. I love the water.
All right. I wish you lots of good luck with that. Now, we mentioned at the outset of this, Jill, that you're going to win $150,000 in cash and prizes. What are you going to do with all that money?
To begin, I just graduated from high school, so of course I'd put some away from for college. Next, I would put it in savings, and finally, I'd like to adopt a giraffe at the city zoo.
From marine biology to giraffes?
No, I was in the third grade, and we were in Brownies, and we were touring the zoo, and there was this little sick giraffe in the corner, and since that day in third grade, I never have forgotten it. And the other day, I was looking through the paper, and it said that they had giraffes up for adoption for about $1,600. So that's what I would do.
I wish you good luck. Thank you very much. Nice
Thank
to
you.
Have you. That's Miss New Mexico. Say hello now to Miss Louisiana, Amy Peach, who is 18 years of age from Ringgold, where she was vice president of her senior class. Is it true in some day in May it was Amy Peach Day in Ringgold?
Yes, I believe it was May the 20th.
What was the occasion? Was it just all to honor you?
No, not really. We had a Slabtown Day, and Slabtown is when we celebrate the beginning of our town. It used to be Slabtown, and being that I was, you know, crowned Miss Louisiana Teen, my town is so small, they were so proud of me, and they were all behind me, and so they wanted to do something really special for me, so they dedicated May the 20th, that's what it was, Amy Peach Day, and I was presented with a plaque by the mayor, and they had a big festival, and I was carried down Main Street in a mule-pulled wagon.
Hey, big day in Ringgold. How many people?
It has about 1,800 people in it.
Did you notice when we started this show these fools out here with the signs? Are you folks still out there? Have you still got... Put your signs up now. I don't know whether Tony Charmley is ready to take a shot of you or not, but there they are. Yes. Oh, you got them all. Peach, there you go.
That's my family.
That's your family?
My friends.
All right, now, do you know everybody in town?
In town where? In Ringgold?
Yeah.
Yes, everybody knows everyone in Ringgold.
They told me you know everybody in the police department.
Yes, I'm related to most everyone in the police department.
Never got a traffic ticket in her life, folks. Take a spot right over here. Thank you so much, Amy. That's Miss Louisiana. Now, here is Miss Illinois. This is Kathleen McClellan, who's 18, a recent graduate of Central Catholic High School. She was an honor student, cheerleader, treasurer of the National Honor Society. Is that your family here to cheer you on?
Yes, they are. They're
and
right
they,
back
they
there.
Got signs just like Amy. You all went to the same printing school there. How big is your family?
Well, I have my parents and my little brother, and then there's my cats, too. I have two cats, and one had kittens right after I won my state title. And we named him Lucky and Dusty and Ned after The Three Amigos, because that's my favorite movie.
How old is that brother you talked about?
He's 7 years old.
Now, you were voted Miss... Is it photogenic or photogenic?
It's photogenic.
Either way, you're a pretty woman. Does he look upon you as a nice-looking person, or is he my ugly old sister?
He thinks I look pretty nice. He's funny because when I won my title, he asked me to come to his school for show and tell to his kindergarten class. And that was really fun. Instead of me going there, we had all of them come to our house for a big picnic. And it was a lot of fun.
Wait a minute. Let me get this straight. Show and tell, who's going to drag you in front of the class, says, "There she is, folks."
He was. He seriously planned on it.
You're what now? What, 11 years apart?
10.
You get along well with him?
Yeah, we get along really well.
It's only going to get better as the years go by.
I hope so.
Thank you so very much.
Thank you.
Miss Illinois. Thank you, ladies, very, very much. Beautiful job. Now, if you're absolutely, positively convinced that you can write down the winner's name on a piece of paper right now, my advice is use a pencil with an eraser, because there's a lot more still to come.
$150,000 in cash and prizes on the line. And 11 judges sitting over there on the front row will decide tonight which contestant is going to change tax brackets. All week long, those same 11 celebrities have been intensely studying and judging all 50 young women. So it's only fair that we get a chance to turn the tables and put the spotlight on them. How about it, Dick?
Absolutely, Tracy. It's time now for some formal introductions. Let's meet our judges. First off, films, records, concerts, and nightclubs have all been a part of the career of this young woman, currently a regular on the hit TV series Amen. Please welcome Roz Ryan. Currently studying acting and modeling, she's already completed an international TV commercial, all this since she left Edmond, Oklahoma, and became Miss Teen USA 1986. This is Allison Brown. He's done Shakespeare in New York, toured in Gospel, and directed television shows in Hollywood, but I guess he's best known to millions as Sonny Mann, the lounge piano player on the TV series It's a Living. Please welcome Mr. Paul Kreppel. Lovely young actress from London who traveled first to Hollywood, then to outer space as counselor Deanna Troi in the TV series Star Trek The Next Generation. She is Marina Sirtis. One of America's most popular evening radio personalities, he's also the host of the new CBS teen show Flip from Kiss FM in Los Angeles, the unpredictable Sean Hollywood Hamilton. At 10, she was granted a scholarship from the School of American Ballet. In addition to being a dancer, she went on to become a top model and starred with Michael Jackson in his video, The Way You Make Me Feel. She is Tatiana Tumsin. He attributes a strong degree of his success as a hairstylist to being on the cutting edge of innovative hair design. He's the owner of the famous Beverly Hills salon Umberto's and style director for Revlon. Please welcome Umberto Savoni. As Almanzo, he was the man who married Laura Ingalls in the long-running series Little House on the Prairie, and now as Moondoggy, he's married to another American favorite in the series The New Gidget. Here is Dean Butler. In 1982, she wrote Go For It, the best-selling book on building confidence and self-esteem, especially for students. Now, as a consultant and spokesperson, she's recognized as one of the foremost experts on teens in America. She's Judy Zarafa. After reigning as Miss USA for 1986, she has since become a host on the Disney Channel and of a travel series. She's also enjoying her 10th year as a professional model. Please greet Kristi Fitchner. He became the first American figure skating gold medalist in 24 years at the 1984 Olympics, and he's about to tour the United States, performing with symphony orchestras in Command Performance on Ice. Please welcome Scott Hamilton. Thank you, judges, one and all. The task ahead of you is a very, very difficult one. Tracy?
There was a lot of work involved in making tonight's pageant a reality here in the Inland Empire, and we'd like to acknowledge some of the community leaders whose cooperation was invaluable. First, the mayor of the city of San Bernardino, Evelyn Wilcox. President of the San Bernardino Host Committee and Executive Vice President of the Economic Development Council, Sam Henley. And the president of the National Orange Showgrounds, Gene Wood. Thank you from all of us.
Coming up next, the second of our semifinal competition, swimsuits, and it happens right after this.
What do you think of when you think of the word beach? Either the boardwalk or maybe palm trees, something like that. Ice cream stands, surfers, surfboards, pretty girls. Hear the waves? I'll tell you what, we've got that and a lot more for you. And we're going to add the excitement of competition to that pop vision of Southern California and come up with our second semifinal round featuring our contestants in their competition swimwear by Catalina Jr. Ladies and gentlemen, here is the 1988 Miss Teen USA swimsuit competition, beginning with Miss Alabama.
Anna is a green-eyed brunette. She is 5 feet, 5 inches tall and weighs 103 pounds. Anna is 18 years old.
This is Miss New Jersey.
Weighing 117 pounds, Michelle stands 5 feet, 5 inches tall. She is 18 years old with blonde hair and green eyes.
Here's Miss Mississippi.
Brown eyes and dark brown hair. She is 16 years old, 5 feet 8 inches tall, and she weighs 110 pounds.
Let's greet Miss Oregon.
Mindy's hair is red and her eyes are blue. She is 16 years old, 5 feet 3 inches tall, and weighs 107 pounds.
This is Miss New York.
Year-old Jessica weighs 107 pounds and is 5 feet 5 inches tall. Her hair is blonde and her eyes are green.
This is Miss West Virginia.
Wendy is 5 feet 7 inches tall and weighs 118 pounds. Her hair and eyes are brown, and Wendy is 18 years old.
Here's Miss Texas.
Libby is 18 years old. She has light brown hair and blue eyes. Weighs 118 pounds and is 5 feet 7 and a half inches tall.
Here's Miss New Mexico.
With dark blonde hair and hazel eyes, Jill is 18 years old. She is 5 feet 6 and a half inches tall and weighs 109 pounds.
This is Miss Louisiana.
Eighteen-year-old Amy is a green-eyed blonde. She weighs 121 pounds and is 5 feet 9 inches tall.
finally, Miss Illinois.
Kathleen is 18 years old. She weighs 123 pounds and is 5 feet 8 inches tall. Her hair is blonde and her eyes are brown.
Ladies and gentlemen, our swimsuit competition is over.